has so much to teach us. Why didn't I see it before?
Thank you. Overseer's Law, town of Flatwoods. My God. There's no one here. The old tavern, the church. People were using them for shelter, but they're gone. Mutations we expected. But there's something else. A disease. I was attacked by... Well, it used to be a person. But it had these green, glowing lesions, and its voice. Angry. Tortured. We are one. One what? Whatever happened here is beyond anything we expected. And we expected a lot. Before they were wiped out, the survivors called themselves the Responders. Looks like they were made of firefighters, police, emergency medical staff. They even have an automated system to teach people about treating water, food, survival. I'm doing their tests, and you should too. I know it's even worse than we imagined, but someone's got to know where the missile silos are and how to secure them. The Responders are the best lead we have. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Hi there. Are you here for the responder training? That's right. They set up a radio signal that's been repeating for years now, calling people here to learn basic survival skills. Unfortunately, the responders are long gone now. But the training system is fully automated, so you can still learn everything you need to. I'm surprised you didn't know that. You must be new around here. Wait a minute. Are you one of those people who was in Vault 76? I keep hearing about it. I've even met some people who say they came from there. And honestly, I believe them. It's so interesting. People living underground for years, and then the doors open, and suddenly there's this whole new world to explore. So, did I guess right? I knew it! I could tell just by looking at you. I've always thought that life in a vault must be so amazing, with the robots and all the machines and having everything you need every day. Best of all, you're safe, which, let me tell you, is a thing us outsiders very rarely get to feel. Though I guess you're one of us now, so that's all in the past for you. Go right ahead. Me? There's not much to tell, really. I came in with Paige and the rest and stayed up at Foundation for a while. It was nice. But eventually I wanted to go my own way, you know? Get out and see some places I'd never seen, figure out who I am. When I heard the message on the radio about Flatwoods, I was curious to meet the responder, so I made my way here. I decided to stay here and see what else I could learn. That's pretty much my story. It's a community of settlers up in the mountains to the east. It's a nice enough place, I guess. That being said, it's a hell of a dangerous trip trying to get there. I barely made it out of the mountains alive. If I were you, I'd keep to the forest until you're ready to deal with some seriously nasty stuff. He's the closest Foundation has to a leader, I guess. I never got to know him real well, but he always seemed like a decent guy. Honest, reliable, cares about the people, that kind of stuff. Okay, what is it? I found it in one of the houses. It fits great, and it's really comfortable and pretty durable, too. I'd also be lying if I said it didn't have some sentimental value for me. I've admired the responders ever since I first heard about them. What they stood for, helping people no matter what, that was really important. Yeah, there's a couple of places around here that qualify as interesting. At least to me. The Agricultural Research Center is infested with feral ghouls and homicidal robots. But you can find some good scrap in there if you're up to it. The New River Gorge Resort to the east is the same story. Maybe, minus the robots. No problem. Here to brush up on your responder survival training?
Sure is great to see living human beings again. With smarts and a little luck, you'll do just fine out there. That overseer lady said more people would be coming. It's nice to meet you. While you're here, why not grab a stim pack or two?
Hi. Dasa asked me if I would talk about, how I got here. She asked everybody, so I said okay. My name's Colonel, and I'm 13 years old. I just wanted to say I'm sorry. I'm sorry for everything. The bombs and the messed up people and the cows with two heads and all of it. I was bad. Just bad. I cheated on my spelling test. I kicked Chip Wilkins in the shins until he cried. I pushed Rosie McCloy down the stairs. I cut holes in the bottom of all the gym shorts and I put glue in the mashed potatoes in the cafeteria. I told Harold Newell to eat 10 dead flies a day in order to grow muscles, and I put Nuka-Cola in the rat cage water bottles at the pet store. And, I just wanted to say I'm sorry about everything. Because my dad said if I wasn't this way, the bad things wouldn't happen. I haven't seen Daddy since the bombs, and I guess he left because of that, too. It's okay. I'm trying to be good now, though. I'm not old enough to be a volunteer, but Dasa said I could help collect food and water, so I'm getting better. I promise.
I bet this town was really nice before the war.
Daddy, if you're listening, I promise I won't be bad anymore, so you can come back now. Okay.
Go to the graveyard behind the church. The right phone. outermost grave. Stand on it. Walk directly across the river. Halfway up the hill, there's a small clearing. My savings are in an old stump. A little bit off the right, I swear. Please. Don't leave me here, please. I'm begging you, please.
Thank you.
Automated warning to all responders. The Mr. Farmhands are out of control. Evacuate civilians. And take down those supervisors. Once they're dealt with, you'll have to reboot the server. Again.
DASA has asked us all to document our stories for posterity, you know. Seems like a fine idea. So, hi, I am Kesha McDermott. When the bombs fell, I was in Watoga, coordinating a statewide science fair for that year's high school kids. And the theme was the future of energy. After the bombs, everything was pretty chaotic. Scavenging for food and fighting off rabid survivors. Oh, it was just a bad time all around. I found a couple of surviving kids from the high school whose parents didn't make it. And we holed up in a house in town for a while. After a bit, I was able to solder the circuitry in an old radio, and we tuned in to a broadcast from the responders. Oh, we were overjoyed. The trip from Watoga to Flatwoods, it was rough, mind you. The kids and I ran into a group of assholes in the mountains who stole our food and water. I can't tell you how happy I was to find the responders in Flatwoods. Tents for everyone, open kitchens, medical supplies, protection. We were safe. They had a problem, though. Their water sources were contaminated heavily. People were boiling water, but not long enough to make it safe. So, I stepped up and I said, I'll build a testing kit to monitor contamination, and I will teach folks how to properly boil water. And I did. The world is getting better, but slowly. We need to make sure it doesn't relapse, too. It's going to take time and care, that's all. Well, time, care, and science.
Detecting potential
Intruder, identify yourself.
Alert! Possible source of compostables detected. potential source found. Initialize scanning protocol. New source of compostables found. Detecting potential composting target. Continuing composting operations.
Proceed to the Ag Center and get to the mainframe. You need to reset the farmhand targeting parameters. That should keep our people safe in the area. Be careful.
Thank you.
Returning to normal operations.
Soil.
equipment contaminated. Assistance required. Equipment contaminated. Assistance required. Equipment
Attention
contaminated.
Citizens. Nuclear
assistance
strike imminent.
Required.
Please exit the area at your earliest convenience. Thank you for your cooperation.
It sure is great to see living human beings again. While you're here, why not grab a stim pack or two?
Hi there.
To meet you. With smarts and a little luck, you'll do just fine out there.
Thank you.
contaminated. Assistance required. Equipment 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 contaminated. Assistance required. Thank you. equipment contaminated. Assistance required.
Overseers, let's call these personal journals. Not an official log, just something for me. The Agricultural Center, one of my first posts with Vault Tech. I was so excited because I used to come to this same farm when I was a kid. I remember one year at the Autumn Festival, me running through the corn maze. Going every which way, Mom and Dad yelling after me to slow down. Wasn't gonna happen. I guess I was always hitting life fast. Couldn't just be a pioneer scout, I had to make troop leader. Couldn't just be a good student. I had to have straight A's. God, I miss those early days. Just being a kid, the three of us, our simple life, our simple house. I wonder if it's still standing.
Thank you. Trade only. Fair. This for that, that for this. Trade. Need the best stuff.
Make yourself at home. I did.
Tonight, we bring you the final chapter of Who Goes There? The Strange Encounter in Flatwoods. In the last episode, Pioneer Scout Fred Fisher met a curious girl named Sally while hiding in the dark. But as it turned out, they weren't alone.
There are other people here?
Yeah, they probably just went to get more food. They'll be back soon enough. You can wait with me, and they'll give you food too. You just have to do what they want.
What do you mean?
When they want to play games with you.
Games? What kind of games?
I'm still learning the rules. Mostly, they're kind of boring, and only hurt when they use the needles.
Needles?
Yeah, you know, like at the doctor.
This doesn't sound like any game I know. It sounds downright awful, and these people sound really bad. We have to get out of here.
No, stay put, stay put, stay put, stay put!
Okay, stop screaming!
Search high and low for a missing girl named Sally, whom he swears he met. So I leave it to you to decide, dear listeners. Was this simply the wild imagination of a frightened boy lost in the woods? Or was Fred Fisher, in fact, abducted by brainwashing aliens from outer space? Be sure to tune in next week for another thrilling chapter of Tales from the West Virginia Hills.
Reverend Delbert Winters here, born and raised in this very town. Lent my own church to the responders for their outpost here, and you're welcome. The responders are on a true mission, you see, helping folks through thick and thin till the heavens open up again and take us all up anyways. When this all happened, I figured like most, it was time. This was the end, but it wasn't, was it? We're still here. At first, I thought it was a mistake, that we was missed, forgotten. Maybe we did some wrong. Didn't give enough to charity, maybe. Didn't praise his name, even in the worst of times. Maybe thought some things that ought not to have been thought. So I asked him. I asked how? Why? I fought your wars on Earth. I'm ready to fight them up there by your side. Then, in my despair, I saw some survivors eating raw rat carcass behind the dumpster. You ought to cook that first, I warned them. It seemed obvious. We tried but got sick, they said, covered in their own filth. I realized right then and there that I was being tasked. From then on, I built kitchens. Cooked good food, fed anyone who walked up with an empty belly, and I was thankful for my task in life. Thankful. time hell or high water land in my stoop, I'll be swept clear away with it. But until then, let's share a home-cooked meal together, all right?
Thank you.
Chloe's my pet. Or maybe I'm hers. I'm not sure.
Says they'll build us a better tomorrow. But can we really trust them?
You buying this keep the peace idea these Brotherhood types are putting down?
Thank you.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. I'm home. Sorry it's been so long, but I couldn't get away. I know neither of you is around to hear this, but I miss you. I miss watching Dad grade papers on the living room table. I miss the three of us huddled around the radio, listening to the Silver Shroud. Dad, you were right about what living underground would really be like. 25 years locked in with the same people was a challenge. But watching them pair up, get married, have children, well, I think I got to know a little bit of what you and Mom were always telling me. Well, since I'm doing this whole trip down memory lane, maybe a walk over to the old high school.